don't believe in ghosts or anything. I know that you are gone and that I'm carrying some version of you around. Some untrustworthy old description in my memories. And that must be your ghost taking form, created every moment by me dreaming you so. And is it my job now to hold whatever's left of you for all time, and to reenact you for our daughter's life? I do remember. That life ends and it's just over. That a point comes where we no longer get to say or do anything. And then what? I guess just forgotten. And I said to my mom that I hope to do something important with my life. Not be famous, but just remembered a little more. To echo beyond my actual end. And my mom laughed at this kid trying to wriggle his way out of mortality, of the final inescapable feral scream. But I held that hope and grew up wondering what dying means. Unsatisfied, ambitious, and squirming. The first dead body I ever saw in real life was my great-grandfather's embalmed in a casket in Everett, in a room by the freeway where they talked me into reading a thing from the Bible about walking through a valley in the shadow of death. But I didn't understand the words. I thought of actually walking through a valley in a shadow with a backpack and a tent. That dead body next to me spoke clear and metaphor-free. In December 2001, after having spent the summer and fall traveling mostly alone around the country that was spiraling into war and mania, little flags were everywhere. I was living on the periphery as a 23-year-old, wrapped up in doing what I wanted. And it was music and painting on newsprint, and eating all the fruit from the tree like Tarzan or Walt Whitman. Voracious, devouring life, singing my songs, sleeping in yards without asking permission. That December I was shaken by a pregnancy scare from someone that I'd been with for only one night, many states away, who I hadn't planned to keep knowing. A young and embarrassing, overconfident animal night. Terror of the idea of fatherhood at 23 destroyed my foundation and left me freaked out and wandering around, mourning the independence and solitude that defined me then. Though my life is a galaxy of subtleties, my complex intentions and aspirations decisions do not matter at all. In the face of the crushing flow of actual time, I saw my ancestors as sad and misunderstood, in the same way that my descendants will swim back through a fog trying to see some polluted version of all I mean to be in life. Their recollections pruned by the accidents of time, what got thrown away and what gets talked about at night. But she had her period eventually, and I went back to being 23. Eleven years later, I was traveling alone again on an airplane from New Zealand to Perth, Western Australia. Very alone, so far away from you and the home that we had made. I watched a movie on the plane about Jack Kerouac, a documentary going deeper than the usual congratulations. They interviewed his daughter, Jan Kerouac, and she tore through the history. About this deadbeat drinking, watching Three Stooges on TV, not acknowledging his paternity, abandoning the child, taking cowardly refuge in his self-mythology. And when she spoke, I heard your voice telling me about the adults who had abandoned you as a sweet kid, left you to grow precariously. And when she spoke, I looked in her face and saw you looking back at me. On a tiny airplane seat screen at the bottom of the world, I saw a French-Canadian resemblance and heard suffering echoing. A lineage of bad parents and strong daughters withstanding. And she had black hair and freckles and pale skin just like you, and she told the hard truth and slayed the gods just like you. I saw the cracks in the facade of posterity. I missed you, so I went home. The second dead body I ever saw was you, Genevieve, when I watched you turn from alive to dead right here in our house. I looked around the room and asked, are you here? And you weren't, and you are not here. I sing to you though. I keep you breathing through my lungs in a constant, uncomfortable stream of memories trailing out until I am dead too. Eventually the people who remember me will also die, containing what it was like to stand in the same air with me and breathe and wonder why. And then distortion, and then the silence of space. The night palace, the ocean blurring, but in my tears right now, light gleams.